Hot winds across Australia are predicted to widen the country's bushfire crisis, with temperatures currently above 40 degrees in South Australia, prompting catastrophic alerts. Tasmania is also predicted to see its worst ever conditions later this week. Six people have died since last month in New South Wales and Queensland, where 500 homes were destroyed. Sydney was covered in bushfire smoke yesterday, with paramedics treating 60 people for health complications caused by the haze. Residents in Sydney's Hawkesbury area are still on alert as the Gosper Fire has more than doubled in size since last week. Alex Perrottet reports.
The Gosper Mountain Fire is now over 160,000 hectares in size and 300 kilometres wide, with wind changes making it very hard to fight. The Mayor of Hawkesbury, Barry Calvert, says parts of the national park are hard to get into and they're also fighting it from the air.
They've got planes in there and they've got a couple of lines that they've made out of the pink retardant, and they're trying to use that as a defence line, and planes with and helicopters with buckets are defending that line. So, yeah, they're using aircraft quite a lot.
Steve Shoemaker runs the outdoor adventure company on Webb's Creek and says the smoke has been bad there as well. He's had to cancel camp bookings and says he's never seen anything like it.
Enormous, and I've lived in the bush my whole life and I've never seen a backburn of the size that they're putting in at the moment. I mean, it's just huge.
He says he feels safe thanks to the extensive backburning done around his property over the last few weeks.
People should be thanking the RFS, volunteers and that are working tirelessly to try and contain this, to be honest.
Firefighters had to save Colo Heights Public School just days ago, and the school has been forced to close until further notice. Henriette de Conning runs the Glossodia Scout Group and has put a notice on Facebook offering the Scout Hall for families that may have to evacuate the suburb of Colo Heights.
And we do have a few families that are a member of our Scout Group that live in Colo Heights, so that's why we thought, oh, well, we better put it out there that if people need shelter, then we are available and we can open up the hall and, people could stay there, can bring some animals because we do have some space there.
She says there's water and food supplies and other donations. Henriette's husband, Pete, is a firefighter for the Rural Fire Service and has been out on the fire grounds, and she says they expect to be fighting it for weeks.
But they do expect deterioration of the conditions tomorrow and, into the weekend. Yeah, some moments we are completely covered in smoke and really smells like fire, and then the next day if the wind changes, it kind of clears up again. But there is this general kind of haze.
Henriette says she's already moved her valuable possessions and photo albums to another safe location, as has Barry Calvert. He says firefighters are briefing him every day, but the winds are making it very hard to contain.
They're hoping that it doesn't come any further south because that's where the population is. And they think they can stop it from coming further south, but really depends on the weather.
Barry Calvert says the Hawkesbury Showground is still hosting plenty of local pets and farm animals, as well as a few exotic ones.
We've got a menagerie of horses and goats and chickens and lizards at the moment.
And lizards?
Lizards, yep. Yeah. Someone collects lizards and they brought in these big tanks full of lizards. Yeah.
For Checkpoint, Alex Perrottet.
And in breaking news, people living in Victoria's north and northwest have been urged to leave their homes as soon as possible as the region faces the worst fire conditions in 10 years.